All right, so today I'm going to explain a little bit about the cooling system, like the radiator and the thermostat on a Jeep Grand Cherokee. This applies towards a lot of different vehicles, though. So first of all, we have the radiator cap here. What the radiator cap does is, first of all, it allows, you know, it's a lid for your radiator, but it also is made up of a few different parts. We got the spring inside of there. It's temperature sensitive. So like when it gets really hot, the spring contracts and allows this part of it, the lid of it, to shrink down inside of it just like that, allowing more space to pass through. The reason it does that is because you can see here on the radiator, there's a little hose right here. So when the cap is fully on and cool, this is expanded all the way. But as soon as the radiator starts to heat up, this contracts, allowing the fluid to escape through this line and go into the reservoir, the coolant reservoir over there. Then we have the thermostat, which is kind of the same concept, but this contracts to allow the coolant to enter into the engine itself. So if you ever get to a point where your engine or your radiator is just boiling over with the radiator fluid, it's one of these two parts, either the radiator cap or the thermostat. So the thermostat usually goes, you know, towards the top of the engine. In this case, it goes right here inside of this little contraption. So the radiator fluid comes out through here and goes down, but only when the engine is hot enough. And so you can get these at varying degrees. This one is a 195. You can kind of see it right there. I replaced mine with a lower one, a 180, just so I can get the coolant in there quicker. So that's kind of how the cooling system works on a Jeep. But yeah, like I said, it applies towards lots of different vehicles. Anyway, if you liked, you know, the information, or if you want to see more videos on Jeep repair or basically anything else, go ahead and feel free to subscribe and like if this helped you.